One day, a professor entered his classroom and asked his students to prepare for a surprise test. They all waited anxiously at their desk for the task to begin. The professor handed over the question paper with the text facing down as usual. Once he had handed them out to each student, he asked the class to turn over the paper and start writing. To everyone's surprise, there were no questions, just one black dot in the center of the sheet of the paper. The professor, seeing the expression on everyone's face, he told them that he wanted them to write about what they saw on the question paper. The students, confused, got started on the inexplicable task, each trying to brainstorm and decide the puzzling question. At the end of the class, the professor took all the papers and started reading each answer out loudly. All of them, with no exception, defined the black dot, trying to explain its position in the center of the sheet, how little it was, its radius, the thickness, the color of black, etc. At the end of the allotted time, the professor collected all the answer sheets and said, "I'm not going to grade you on this. I just wanted to give you something to think about." No one wrote about the white part of the paper. Everyone only focused on the black dot alone. And the same happens in our lives. We have a white piece of paper to observe, describe and enjoy, but we always focus on the dark spots. Friends, we have lots to enjoy and be thankful for, but we insist on focusing on the dark spots, the health issues that bother us, the lack of money, the regret with the choices that we have made, the dissatisfied job, the lack of friends, the disappointments with friends or parents, or lack of joy or happiness in life. Sometimes we let the little black dots multiply and join until they threaten to completely obscure the potential of everything else around us. The dark spots are very small when compared to everything we have in our lives, but they are the ones that pollute our mind and depress our hearts. The dark spots are small compared to the vast white canvas of our lives. We need not allow them to take over our hearts and our minds. Don't let the black dots fill the pages of your life. Paint your own color pictures. Life is a mixed bag of good and bad things. Everyone has his share of positives and negatives along the way. But what we must always lay greater emphasis in the positives of a healthy and a happy life. The formation of a pearl acts as a metaphor in the story of the black dot. Oysters form pearls in response to an irritant. Now, when a grain of sand or any other object falls between the shell and the mantle, the oyster produces nacre, a strong and a resilient composite material to protect itself from the irritation. The jam is formed from layers of more nacre coating over the irritant. Thus, the oyster creates a gemstone. The story of the oyster and the resultant jam helps us to see that we need not gloss over the black dots in our life. Ignoring them won't make them go away, but in fact, if the irritant gets unaddressed, it might even cause some serious damage. So we need to deal with it in some way in the same way that the oyster does. It takes work, energy and time to change the irritant into a beautiful pearl. The lovely pearl isn't created suddenly. Likewise, we need to wrap our irritations in perseverance, in patience or forgiveness, one layer at a time, while focusing on the brighter side of life. A few statistics will help all of us to put focus on the white spots in our life. Point number one, on an average, there are approximately 56 million deaths a year in the world, which is more than 1.5 lakh people die every day, or rather 2 deaths per second. Second, around 9 million people die every year of hunger and hunger-related disease, while a child dies from hunger every 10 seconds in the world. One in every seven children is born underweight, while there are over 149 million children that are stunted because of poor nourishment. According to World Bank data, over 3.4 billion people earn just $5.5 a day and are on the verge and a medical bill away from sinking into abject poverty. They don't have basic health care. They are just a crop failure from sinking back into utter poverty, while there are over 700 million people living in this world on less than $2 a day. Marcus Aurelius, a Roman emperor, once said, "When you arise in the morning, think of what a precious privilege it is to be alive, to breathe, to think, to enjoy, and to love." Getting a new day to breathe, to think, and to enjoy, and to love might not seem to be that important for you as you get them on a regular basis, even when you do not crave for them. However, the moment you start looking for them, you will be able to understand the value of it. So friends, take your eyes away from the negative situations or perceived disadvantages in your life. Try feeling more about the positives, which are usually much larger. Only then you can gain enough joy, thanksgiving, and momentum to overcome the little black dots